Hello, so in this series of Know Your Hormones, I'm going to talk about the various hormones and the role that they play in our body. So today I'm going to talk to you about prolactin. Now prolactin is a very, very important hormone. It is secreted by the pituitary gland and it is responsible for lactation. So in everyday language, prolactin is also referred as the milk hormone, because it increases the quantity of milk secretion, especially after pregnancy. What are the functions of prolactin? The main function of prolactin, as we can see, is production of milk. But there are over 300 other functions that have been identified that are responsible as a result of prolactin. So it can be reproductive functions, it can be metabolic functions, it can be regulation of fluids in your body, regulation of your immune system, your behavioral functions. All these functions are also as a result of the prolactin in your body. What regulates prolactin? Now we see that all these hormones, there is a certain system in our body which is a very, very intelligent system. It is either because of positive feedback or negative feedback. So the body has this immense kind of mechanism which plays a very synchronous role, and it regulates the hormones in our body depending on the requirement. Now dopamine is another hormone which restrains the production of prolactin. So the more dopamine is there, the amount of prolactin will be reduced. This is a very, very important function of dopamine and a way to control excess amount of prolactin in your body. Estrogen, another hormone, is known to increase the production and secretion of prolactin from the pituitary gland. So you can observe that this kind of functions and interrelation between hormones is very, very essential in our body, and this is the way our body is regulating the secretion of these kind of hormones. What has research shown us? Research has shown us that prolactin secretion increases with anger and from humiliating experience. No doubt that we are seeing a large amount of women coming with something known as prolactinoma, or increase in secretion of prolactin. So researchers have found out that there is a definite relation between the anger and between humiliating experiences. All this causes an increase in the production of prolactin. What happens when there is an increase in the prolactin level? What can it cause? First, it can cause unwanted milk production. Ideally, we should have milk production when the woman has delivered the baby. So lactation is important, and at that time, if you have good amount of prolactin, it will help. But at other times, if the prolactin increases, then you will have unwanted milk production. In women, it can disrupt the menstrual cycle. It can cause weight gain. It can cause abnormal hair growth in women. It can cause infertility. It can cause loss of libido. So all these things can happen if there is an excess in prolactin in your body. Now, if there is a decrease in prolactin, then automatically, as we can see, there will be insufficient milk production after giving birth. What we know is most of the people with low prolactin levels will not come with any specific medical problem or any specific symptoms. But research has shown that low prolactin levels can cause an immune response to be compromised and make you more prone to infections. So the idea is to have a balance of prolactin and all the other hormones. Now, what are the natural ways of increasing or natural ways of controlling the prolactin? So as we know, if we have enough dopamine in our body, automatically the levels of prolactin will remain in control. So dopamine is a pleasure-giving chemical in your body. It is released when you do something which you feel happy about, something that makes you feel elated. This can release, this dopamine can then control the excessive amount of prolactin in your body. And to have naturally high dopamines, what can you do? You should live every moment joyfully. The more you live joyfully, the more amount of dopamine will be released in your body and your prolactin will be under control. You can eat proteins, you can reduce this amount of saturated fats in your body. You can consume probiotics. All this will help you to naturally increase your dopamine levels and thereby decrease the prolactin levels in your body. So, regular exercise, enough sleep, music, meditation and sunshine, all these things can help you to increase the dopamine level and reduce the prolactin levels naturally. So this was a brief